after we make the connection, we set the light intensity to 10 milliwatt using this knob. We vary the voltage using this knob. For different values of voltage, we note down the micro ammeter reading. The voltage is initially set to 0.1 volt. At this value of voltage, we get a value around -6 micro ammeter. The values are negative. That indicates that we have connected the photodiode in the reverse bias condition. When we plot the graph, we plot the graph in the third quadrant, wherein we have both x and y axis to be negative. And now we increase the voltage to next value, that is 0.2 volts, and the corresponding microammeter reading is noted. Then the voltmeter is set to the next value, that is 0.3 volts. The corresponding microammeter reading is noted, and then it is set to 0.4, and the microammeter reading, which is -264, which is noted in the tabular column. Further, we increase the voltage by 0.1 volt, that is, we set it to 0.5, and then we note down the microammeter reading. Further, it is increased to 1 volt, and the corresponding ammeter reading is noted. And then it is increased to 2 volts. The corresponding microammeter reading is noted in the tabular column. And now we bring the knob to minimum, and then the power of the LED is changed to next value using this knob, that is to 20 milliwatt. And the experiment is repeated again for different values of voltage, which is set using this knob, and the corresponding microammeter reading is noted. And the next trial that we repeat is that we set the intensity of the LED to 30 milliwatt, and the experiment is repeated for the same set of voltages that we have done it previously. And the graph is plotted in the third quadrant by considering the voltage along x-axis and the microammeter reading along y-axis for the three trials that we have noted in the tabular column.